The hoodwinked youth say they formed an association called Lango NRM Cadres Association with Basil Odiek as the chairperson, Vicky Atim as the secretary, and Nelson Ochen as the treasurer. The victims say these three duped them into contributing 220,000 shillings each for t-shirt and transport to travel to Kampala to meet the president. Robin Weche, who has for long nursed dreams of meeting President Museveni, says they were promised once they met the president, he would give them 5 million shillings each, plus iron sheets and cement. He says a few of them were taken to Kampala after paying another 90,000 shillings and dumped on the streets before they were rescued by one Patrick Ogwang Obura, who works at the NRM secretariat.
We were taken to Kampala, and then there was nowhere we went. We only packed at the gate. Then they said they are going to see the prime minister, they are going to see the Mao. And when we went to the secretariat, they told us to remove our shirts because there is nothing that exists like that. When we got to Ogwang Obura, he told us clearly that NRM don't collect any money from anyone. But if we collect money and want to see the president, we need to follow the formal procedure. And he advised us to write a letter. From there, we wrote a letter that they are going to meet us on 28th of November. But still, we waited, nothing happened.
Robin Ongom, another victim, says he was conned of about 310,000 shillings and he wants the trio to pay up.
I'm here because I'm looking for my money. There's a conman who have come and conned us in the name of NRM. they came and collect money from in the name of the one take us to prison.
Jackie Akulu, a resident of Alito Camp, says she was conned by the same suspects. Some three people, Vicky Atim, Nelson Uchen, and Odiek Basil, came to us and said they were leaders of Lao NRM Cadres Association. They told us they were looking for people to join them, and we expressed interest since we support the NRM party. They told us to contribute some money for transport before we met the president, and that good things await us. Masi Akelo says the same suspects also conned them of an additional 10,000 shillings, purportedly for hosting the First Lady Janet Museveni, who was coming to meet them. They told us that the First Lady was coming in December last year, so we should contribute 10,000 shillings to host her. The Divisional Police Commander Ivan Tenua says the suspects who conned people of over 50 million shillings will be taken to court. He says the scam had been going on for long until they were tipped off. He also warned the youth against living in ignorance, which makes them vulnerable to con men and con women.
Such cases should always consult. You have nearest police stations, nearest police posts, you have got the DPCs and other stakeholders within the community. You need to consult. There's no way you can go and meet the president and they're supposed to pay money. How? It has never happened, and I don't tolerate such nonsense within the city. And I encourage my fellow divisional police commanders, DPCs, to be on the lookout for these three suspects. And I'm quite sure they won't stop now. Even after we are taking them to court, they may be bailed out, they'll be bounced back in the very districts. So we're on the lookout onto them, and I encourage my fellow DPCs to do the same.
Meanwhile, the 2nd Division Military Court Martial sitting in Kisoro District has handed a life sentence to a UPDF officer. Private Hamis Walimbwa shot dead 18-year-old Zephyrine Nizeimana on the 2nd of June last year while at Friends Bar in Rukundo Town Council, Kisoro District. Walimbwa, who is attached to Kibaya Army Detachment at the Uganda-DRC border, shot and injured his fellow soldier, Private William Acha, in the mix. The incident happened at around 11:30 p.m. It is said Walimbwa lost his temper before opening fire. His colleague Achia tried to intervene and took a bullet to the leg.
The convict now, before this honorable court, pleaded guilty to the offense of murder and attempted murder.
Prosecution maintained that Walimbwa contravened the rules of UPDF and the Constitution, which mandates soldiers to protect civilians and their property.
Should handle his actions of causing death of a civilian and injuring his colleague as serious and grievous in nature, which warranted him out of society.
But Olimbwa's lawyer, Mark Okondi, pleaded with the court to give the convict a lighter sentence, saying he was intoxicated with alcohol.
And there is no record that he had ever discharged a bullet recklessly for those 20 years he has been on service. This therefore calls for a moral responsibility of the convict for the offense with which he is charged.
Olimbwa asked the court to forgive him. He was given a life sentence on murder charges and another life imprisonment on attempted murder charges. Kitwala directed that Olimbwa serve the sentences concurrently at Ndorwa Government Prison in Kabale District.
Therefore, sentences you to life imprisonment on the count of murder, and has sentenced you to life imprisonment to the second count of attempted murder. Both sentences be served concurrently.
Report by Hudson Aponyo and Job Namanya for the news.